Hello and welcome to this video where we're going to talk about the creating a Lansweeper site and installation process. To start with, we're going to log into Lansweeper, create a Lansweeper site. From there, we're going to take and download the installer and, of course, go through the installation steps. Once that's finished, we're going to go through the process of syncing your installation to a Lansweeper site that you've recently created. So let's talk about minimums for a moment. Ideally, you want to have a local admin rights for those machines that you're scanning with Windows-based machines. If you're scanning a Linux, a Unix, or SSH, really all you need are read-only rights. For a scan target, you really want to be looking at an IP range that includes the different Windows, Linux, SSH, networking devices in order to get a good understanding of what Lansweeper's capabilities are. Lastly, really, I would encourage you to have internet access for that server that's doing that scanning. That way you can access the Lansweeper sites. Now, if you want to have a little bit more geeky details the way I like to do this, I also like to get in and have it scan Active Directory. You can go through the process of an ADOU only or scan the entire domain. Something else you might want to consider is the vCenter environment or a virtual environment that you're currently using as well. Another area you may want to consider is also having it scan out into your AWS, your Azure, different types of environments up in the cloud. With that, you'll have a very well-rounded understanding of what Lansweeper can do. So with that, let's jump into Lansweeper and see what this is all about. All right, so first we need to browse here to app.lansweeper.com. And at this location, we can log into your account, or if you're brand new, we're going to want to register. So let's go into register. Let's put in my email and my password, making sure that you have all the requirements here with the uppercase, lowercase characters and a number and so forth. Of course, accepting the terminologies, the terms of use and the privacy policy. Please feel free to read either of those if you are in question and want to have more information. Then we're going to hit next. All right, now that we're here, you want to pick a name for your site. Depending on your specific environment and what you're trying to do, you may want to actually have a name of the physical location or maybe a building name or the company name. That's going to be kind of up to you on what you're going to want to do and how you're going to use Lansweeper. For this situation, I'm just going to make this be my company name and create my site. So at this point, my Lansweeper site has been created. I'm currently logged in, and I just need to download my IT scanner and get this installed. So let's click on this scanner. And once this finishes downloading, we're going to go right into this installation process. All right, now that this is downloaded and we're ready to do the install, I'm going to double click, tell it to run. All right, again, the terms of use, I'm going to hit accept. At this point, we have a choice to be made. This is where you can make a choice on your type of installation depending on the trial you're trying to do. An easy installation is going to be a simple next, next, next install, and it will move on. The advanced installation is going to be dependent upon your style and your type of environment that you have. The advanced installation will allow you to use a proxy server, choose the type of SQL installation that you're going to have. How many scan servers you have will also determine the type of SQL installation you're going to need. For this particular installation, we're going to choose an easy install because it's going to be a next, next, next. The SQL version will be a SQL local DB and will allow for only one single Lansweeper scanner. All right, let's select the easy installation. So while this is installing, there's a couple components that are being installed into your installation right now. You've got the scan server that's going to do the scanning in the environment. It's also installing the local DB, SQL local DB that is included with Lansweeper. The other thing it's included and installing is the IIS Express installation. So that way there's an on-prem web console as well. By default, for cloud-based applications that may be disabled, you can look into the knowledge base articles at community.lansweeper.com to find out more information on how you can access the on-prem installation. All right, now with this being finished, I'm going to click on Finish and it will take me to my site. It's now asking me, what do I want to do with my Lansweeper installation? In this situation, I'm going to be selecting the Choose the Cloud Management. This is another choice down here where you can choose the on-premise management as well, which gives you a little bit different view and a little bit of different access to your Lansweeper installation. For our demo here and a trial, I would recommend that we choose the cloud management. All right, now that the Lansweeper installation has gone through and checked your pre-qualifications to make sure that all the connections are going to work correctly, it's asking us for the linking code. This linking code can be found inside of the Lansweeper installation where we first created our account. I'm going to click on Get Linking Code, and here's my entire code right here. Copy the code, and we can come down here and paste the code right here, and click Next. As it's saying, this is linking to the site, and it's going through the very first installation and the very first connection and syncing. While this is syncing and processing right now, what's happening in the back end is Lansweeper is scanning your first subnet or VLAN that it's currently connected to. That way it's going to discover any assets, any information that happens to be on that particular network that will be then synced up to your cloud where you can view it right here. All right, now that we're scanning, we can see that the scanning is in process and we can see the different activity that's going on, checking the different IPs and finding out what's in this particular VLAN where I am installed. And you can see in my VLAN, I had 360 there, and it's now slowly going through this process. Any machines that servers that it discovers, you'll see them over here in the second screen and the second window there, and it will display what is being found there. And finally, this third window, we will see which assets have been brought into our Lansweeper environment. All right, and I think that concludes this video. What we have done today is creating a Lansweeper site. We have downloaded the installation and gone through that installation process, syncing it over to the cloud where you can see assets being brought in. If you need more information about the requirements necessary to make Lansweeper work in your environment, I encourage you to go over to community.lansweeper.com where you can discover more requirements necessary for switches and routers and firewalls, as well as the local machines that you'll be scanning. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. I look forward to seeing you on the next one.